Hi everyone, in this video we will discuss basics of algebra and the definitions of all the important terms that we frequently encounter in algebra. For example, we have expressions, terms, constant, variable. We will see all of them one by one. Now before we start our class, I will strongly recommend you to join our Telegram group, MathOffer Telegram group, because there you will get class notes. So once this class is over, I will put the PDF notes there and the PDF notes will be annotated. So whatever I write here, all will be there. You can find the link in the description. Okay, so we can start now. So before we proceed to understand what is algebra, let us first focus on arithmetic. So in arithmetic, we have generally two entities. We have numbers and we have operators. So in numbers, you will get generally like 78, 7, 10. In operators, we will get addition, subtraction, division, multiplication. Now, for example, let us take an example here. So, let's say we have 78 and I want to add 12 here. So, if I add, then I will get 100. Sorry, that would be 90. Let us make this 22. So if I add 22 in 78, then I will get 100. Now in algebra, almost all these things are same. The only difference would be, let us say this 78 is renamed as a variable. We will discuss what is variable. Let us say we have a alphabet here, X, and 22 is same. So here if I add, then I don't know what would be my value, because I don't know what is the value of X. So this is unknown for me. Right, so we can write our answer as x plus 22. Now my answer would depend on what is the value of this unknown x. So let's say if x is 1, then my answer would be 23. If my x is 5, then my answer would be 27. If my x is 18, then my answer would be 40. If my x is 78, then my answer would be 100. So the answer is not fixed here, it is dependent on this unknown value, and that is the difference between arithmetic and algebra. Here you have greater generality. Rest all is same. Here you have more freedom to choose some values for your chosen unknown quantities, and then your answer would be dependent upon them. Rest all the operations are almost same to arithmetic. So in one word, if in one statement we want to define algebra, then we can say that algebra is arithmetic plus, you can say, greater generality. Okay, now we will see one by one all the important terms. The first term is constant. Constant is nothing but number that have a fixed numerical value. For example, we have say 100, or you can say 500, 17, all the numbers will be treated as constant. Then we have variable, a letter or term that represents unknown. So in this example, this x is my variable. So we can have x, we can represent it as y, any alphabet value, you can take p, q, r, and so on. Then we have term. A term is mixture of these two. It could be constant, so constant is also a term. A variable is also a term, and if you multiply these two, then also you will get a term, a constant times one or more variable. So you can take example, let's say 77, this is constant as well as term. Let's say we have p, that is constant as well as that is variable as well as term, and let's say I multiply, let's say we have 7c, this would be a term. This is a multiplication of a constant and a variable. Let's say we have 17 x, y, z. So there is a constant and there are three variables x, y, and z, and this whole will be known as a term. So I hope these three important terms are clear: constant, variable, and term. Now we will discuss algebraic expression. Now algebraic expression is a collection of symbols containing one or more terms and some mathematical operations. So for example, if we have, let's say we have 10a, 5b, and if I put minus sign here, so I have two terms here, 10a, this is term 1, 5b term 2, and I also have a operator here, arithmetic operator, subtraction operator, subtract operator. So this would be known as a expression. This would be an expression because this is a collection of symbols containing two terms and it is joined by a mathematical operation. Now we divide expressions into two parts. One is simple and another is compound. Compound is further divided into three parts, which is binomial, trinomial and multinomial. Now this term, this nomenclature depends on the number of terms available in your expression. So if you have only one term, then you will know, you will say that my expression is simple or the name is monomial. Both are interchangeable. So there would be only one term in monomial. Now in compound expressions, based on the number of terms available, if you have two terms, then you will say that your expression is binomial. If you have three terms, then you will say that your expression is trinomial. And if you have more than three terms, then you will say multinomial. So we can take an example for all. So let's say 7a. So this is monomial. For binomial, you can say 7a minus 5b. For trinomial, you can say 7a minus 5b plus 3c. For multinomial, you will need more than three terms. So 7a minus 5b, 3c minus 4d. So here terms are 4. So this nomenclature is not that important, but it is better to know because there is a whole chapter dedicated to this binomial theorem. So it is good to know the names. Now we will see what is a product. So when two or more quantities are multiplied, the result is known as product. So for example, 2 and 3. So if I multiply these two, then I will get 6. So this would be known as my product. So for example, here we have two variables, p and q, so that would be known as pq. And notations would be 3, so you can either denote by pq or you can have a dot operator here or you can have multiplication sign there. Now there is a difference between arithmetic and algebra here. Now for example, let's say we have 7 and 3. If I multiply these two, then I will write 21. But let's say we have A and B. In algebra, what we will do? I can write this in three ways. I can write this as AB without any operator, A dot B or A into B. But the same thing you can't do in arithmetic. This is algebra, this is fine. Can you write 7 into 3 as 7, 3? No, right? Because 7, 3 does not mean 7 into 3, it doesn't mean 21, it means 7 into 10 plus 3. So that is a difference between arithmetic and algebra when you multiply two quantities. So you can't write, you cannot eliminate the dot or any operator in arithmetic. So that's the difference. Also, one more important thing, that order does not matter. It is true for arithmetic as well, right? So 2 into 3 is 6. If I write 3 into 2, that will be also 6. Same thing, A into B is AB. I can write B into A. That would be BA, but it is same as AB or AB, like all these three are same, all these four are same. So order does not matter for product in either arithmetic or algebra, both cases. Now we will discuss factors. So all the quantities that form product are known as factors. So for example, we have term here 15x by z. Now this would be made from 3 into 5 into x 2 by into z. So all of these will be known as factors. Also, a combination of any two of these will be also a factor. So for example, if I choose 3 and 5, so 15, this would be also a factor. Let's say I choose 3 and y, 3y would be also a factor. Let's say I choose 3 by z, that would be also a factor. So either the individuals or any combination of those will make a factors. Even 15x by z as a whole, that would be also a factor. right? You can relate it with arithmetic. So for example, in arithmetic you do, let's say you have 6. 6 will be made from 1, 2 and 3, right? So you will say that 1, 2 and 3 are factors, but you will also say that 1 into 2, that will be 2, is also a factor. 6 will be also a factor and all those things, right? So same way combinations will be also a factor, right? Now we will discuss an important term here, coefficient. Now coefficient is defined in two ways generally. The first would be numeric factor of a term that contains variable. So this is a term 7xy and it contains variable. So the number associated with the variables is coefficient. So 7xy, 7 will be called as coefficient. But this is not strictly, you can say, restricted to number size only. You can have of any factor of a product as the coefficient of remaining factors. So here if you see, we have 18x by z, and if someone asks you that what is the coefficient of y, so what I will do is 18xyz. The coefficient is asked for y, so I will omit this, and whatever is remaining I will say that this is my coefficient 18xz. So this would be my coefficient. So usually the confusion arises because people generally think that coefficient is only a number, but in broader sense it is defined as any factor remaining, you can say any combination of variables that is remaining from the expression. So any factor of a product as the coefficient of remaining factors. So here we wanted y, so I omitted y and all the remainings are 18xz. So that would be treated as my coefficient. We can take more examples. So let's say we have 35 x square by q z w, and here we will see coefficient of, let's say coefficient of by q, coefficient of z, coefficient of say 7, coefficient of w. So for coefficient of yq we omit this and we will say that 35x square zw. So the remaining, whatever is remaining, you can say that that is my coefficient. For z omit this and the remaining is 35x square by cube w. For 7 we have 7 into 5, 35, right? So we can say 5 x square by cube z w. For w you can say 35 x square by cube z. So I hope it is clear now that it is not restricted to a number only, it could be anything. Now we will discuss power or index of a variable or term. So in arithmetic you must have seen, like, let's say 7 raised power 2, so that is 49. And how did you arrive at this? You wrote 7 into 7, so you multiplied the number by itself and then you got the higher power. Now the same way we can do for variables or terms in algebra as well. So let's say we have a and I want its fourth power, then I will write a raised power 4. And I will multiply a by a 4 times. We can do it for terms as well. So let's say we have abc and I want second term, second power. So we can say a square b square c. So it is same as numbers that we do in arithmetic. We can proceed in same manner. Now one thing to note is that there is a difference between coefficient and index or power. So don't have to confuse between them. It is clear by now, but still let's say we have 7 into a raised power 7. So this is my index or power and this is my coefficient, right? So generally index or power is denoted as a superscript, as something as higher, but your coefficient is denoted in contiguous manner, right? It is written side by side with your variable. Now we can denote my product as variables as well, as powers of variables. So let's say we have 7 AABBCCD. So rather than writing this way, we can write this as 7 A is repeated 2 times, then I will write 7 A square. B is 2 times, then I will write 7 B square. C is repeated 4 times, then C raised power 4 and D. So this is better way to write rather than taking this much space. Now we can take more examples. Let's say we have 35 X Y Y Z W. Again 35, x is 1 time, then I will write x. Y is 2 times, then I will write y square. Z is 5 times, so I will write z 5. W is once w. So that's how we can denote if any variable is repeated more than one time, then it's better to write them as a power of that variable. So here a was 2 times, then I wrote, rather than writing a 2 times, I wrote this as a raised power 2. Same goes for V and dashboard. Now for a square root or cube root, again same thing. We know that a square root of 16 is 4. Similarly, let's say cube root of 27, that would be 3. So same way you can do for your terms as well. So let's say we have x square, y square, w square by z raised power 4. And I want square root of this. So I will take this common, and then we can say that x would be now 1 power, y would be 1, w would be, but z is 4, then z raised power 2. So the same way, it is, there is nothing new here. So I hope that is clear to you. Now we will discuss substitution. Now substitution is replacing variables in the algebraic expression with their values. So for example, let's say we have variables a as 10, b as 50, and I have an expression here. So let's say 100 a square by b, and I want to find the value of this expression. Then I will substitute the values at the place of variables, and that is the process which is known as substitution. Replace the variables in algebraic expression with their values. So I will do 100. In place of A, I will put 10. And in place of B, I will put 50. So from here, we will get 100. 10 into 10 by 50. 2 times. So from here, we will get 200. So that is my answer. So this is what substitution is. So now let us discuss a few questions of substitution. So we have a equal to 11, b equal to 7, and c equal to 3. Then we have to find the value of. So the first one, 4046 by 2 raised power 11 minus 25. Now what is the value of 2 raised power 11? If you know the powers of 2, then 2 raised power 10 is 1024. So 2 raised power 11 would be multiplied by 2, 2048. So 4046 by 2048 minus 25. So from here we will get 4046 by 2023. So this would go by 2 times. So my answer is 2. Now you can pause this video and you can try on your own as well. 22CQ. So C value is 3. V value is 7 and A value is 11. So 11 2 times. So 3 raised power 3 is 27 into 14. Now if you solve this, then you will get 270 plus 108. So that would be 378. Now here we have to solve third power. So we have 49, B is 7. सी इज 3 रेज़्ड पावर 6 बाई 11, ए इज 11 स्क्वायर एंड ए वन थर्ड पावर. नाउ इफ यू नोटिस हियर देन 49 इज 7 स्क्वायर राइट, सो दिस वुड बिकम 7 क्यूब दिस टू एंड वी हैव 3 रेज़्ड पावर 6 एंड हेयर 11 क्यूब. इफ आई टेक 1/3 पावर ऑफ दिस देन दिस वुड बिकम 7 रेज़्ड पावर 1, दिस वुड बिकम 3 रेज़्ड पावर 2, दिस वुड बिकम 11. सो दिस वुड बी 9 × 7 = 63/11. सो आंसर इज 63/11. नाउ दीज 3 क्वेश्चन यू हैव टू ट्राई ऑन योर ओन. सो दीज आर ऑल्सो सब्स्टिट्यूशन क्वेश्चन. A is given 4, B is given as 7, C is given as 3, and you have to find the value of these expressions. You simply have to substitute the values in these expressions and you have to find the value. And once you find the value, please put it in comment section. Once you find all these 3 values, you can write your answer as 1 answer here, 2 here, 3. This would be a good practice for you. This would also mean that you have watched the whole class. So thank you. I hope all the lecture was clear to you. If you have any doubt, then you can always put it in comment section. Also, if you have any suggestions, then also you can put it in our comment section. So thank you again. If you are new to our channel, then you can always subscribe to our channel. We post regular math videos. So thank you.